But after it was demobbed, you can see it's got a very powerful winch underneath, so this probably would have been a tank transporter unit or something like that. And when it was demobbed, it went on and was bought by a timber merchant who used it in his timber extraction business. Until such times as it went out of service and it was left in a shed. It was then found just up the road at Rockley near Horsford, so it hasn't come all that far. It was funfair. Proprietors in Hampshire, and when they finally finished with Quo Vadis the steamer, they replaced it with Quo Vadis the Scammel. And on the Royals Funfair fleet on the road today, you'll find another modern Quo Vadis working as well. They kept the name running on their fleet. Royals used to have a completely Scammel fleet at one time, with highwaymen and this particular pioneer. This pioneer was during the week goods carrying and had seats that they used to pop in the back to take people to church on a Sunday. So this was really very much a utility vehicle. What a way to see the countryside when you're going to church on a Sunday, perched right up on top of those high wheels. An Arctic unit. But 1958, it could even have been a longer wheelbase vehicle, which has been shortened. It was around that time when Albion's were actually building these small Arctic units. They were operating smaller Arctic units in 1958 on the motor drone, the Wall of Death, and this one had actually been working on the Wall of Death for a good few years. Currently being restored, and you'll see it on the showground here in the care of Mr. and Mrs. Gibbs from Swindon. Very nice example there of the six-wheeler articulated tractor that Atkinson's were offering at the time. Atkinson, exactly what it says on the tin. It's the lightweight TK, as you see, with the small wheels, because at this time Bedford's, the heavy goods regulations were coming in, and Bedford's kept it hidden away on the showground so it hasn't got too muddy. But there's the Scammel Explorer in civilian recovery livery, as you see. And now an early 48 Austin K4, new to William Crocker of Bristol, and later went on to Richardson's of Chard, restored 10 years ago, owned by Mr. Sage of Chard in Somerset. Very nice example. It's the petrol engine, Austin. Had a little bit of fuel starvation when it came in, but that was just one of those things. Once again, running in traffic. These older vehicles don't like crawling along any more than modern-day vehicles do. But at least they don't boil up and die permanently. They'll just evaporate the fuel and we can start with the steering wheel on the proper side, as you can see, for export purposes. And it was the first of 8 identical chassis bound for Glasgow. But for some reason or other, it never got that far. It served as a recovery vehicle in Ireland and later returned to low loader work. It was restored probably about 12 years ago now as a ballast tractor, and very effectively pulls all sorts of weight. Tipper. Owned by Mr. Flockton from Bournemouth in Dorset, and I can remember one of these used to work out of Wimborne for years into the 1970s and on beyond that. There's a very nice example there of the J-Type. Version. First registered as a cattle lorry, had various uses since then, so it's lost its cattle float body, and it's now owned by Mr. Creeper from Launceston in Cornwall. See, it's got a very useful beaver tail on there, so his owner can carry tractors or other equipment to the steam shows. 1976 Bedford TK now, and this is, was an Arctic tractor initially, so it was always a short wheelbase, but we can see here converted to a showman's vehicle Now back to OECs again, but the first one we have here of the Mammoth range, the Mammoth Major 8 from 1957. And this is a few 45 there. The shortage is continuing, so it's got a wooden body, as you see. Owned by Mr. Petty there from Partridge Green in West Sussex through the British Army. And if you look at this, imagine it in green, and this is exactly the way it would have been as an army vehicle. It's got the original recovery gear on there, still mounted, and still very, very useful. And they went out into some, they were eagerly acquired by civilian recovery operators, and quite a number of them are actually still being worked. And that's a nice example there. Used to pull the elephant trailer for Botham Circus. And now it's owned by Mr. Parker from Toaster and North. And thank you very much, Julian, for all the work you've done for us this weekend. And as you can see, here's a hopeful AEC owner. He's trying to sell an AEC that he's having to have towed in. Well, that's not typical. It really does go. It's just been just a slight hiccup. But if you'd like an AEC 8-wheeler, go and have a word with this man, because there's something very different for you here. It's a restoration project which has been done very well so far, but something that needs finishing. Now, what a rarity this is, just slipping in below level here, below the level of the commentary box, the 1938 Hillman Utility Pickup. Nothing posh, nothing special. It's a little 10 horsepower Hillman. Not a remarkable vehicle at all. The Hillmans weren't, to be quite honest, they weren't that good, that reliable. But they were absolutely what we needed at the time. Every vehicle of this sort of size was being produced by most vehicle manufacturers as utilities for military purposes around this time. And there's the 1938 version. Very, very few of them have survived. A very rare survivor out there, the Hillman Utility. And it's now owned by Mr. Turby from Sherburne and Dorset. Remarkable survivor from a whole range of vehicles that were literally beaten to death. And it's great to see one here. 1977 now, we're coming forward in time with the F-88 Volvo tractor unit. This was the type of Volvo that we suddenly saw on the roads in the 1970s. The British roads were very much the province of the British lorry. And the Volvo that you see going round the arena now, if you look just behind it, there's the blue Atkinson there in the centre of the arena. That was the British equivalent to this at that time out there on the road. But we couldn't supply enough of the vehicles manufactured in this country. And slowly, the foreign competition came in. They eroded us, not only on delivery times, but sometimes on price as well, but certainly on delivery times. Volvo was very, very keen to get a foothold in this country, and they worked very, very hard to establish it. And that was one of those lorries that was doing it at that time. You can see there, very, very much the continuation of the wartime design, and it's very, very typical with that front axle, which is just back a little bit. In this country, we'd have put the front axle probably a little bit further forward than that. On the continent, they like to dangle bits of bonnet out in front of the axle. Well, we've seen a few trimmer tractors today. We've seen the AEC Matadors, which are converted vehicles for other use. We did see the Unipower, which was a specially built timber tractor. Well, here's the Latil, and this is even more specially built, because the Latil actually is an even narrower wheelbase than the Unipower. You go and tell the owner about it, because he'd like to know what's going on. He's still restoring the vehicle and like to restore it with as much history related accuracy as he can. It's owned by Mr. Blanche of Wellington in Somerset. ARC Roadstone is the 1970 AEC Mercury. Registered in London, worked that area for some years before being brought down to the West Country to end its working life, and has now been restored and rallied by Mr. Simpson from Somerton in Somerset. And this is the 1944 Tank Transporter, later used by a Scottish council as a snow plow, and is owned by Mr. Harding from Alton in Hampshire. Luckily, Mr. Harding doesn't have a lot of pretensions when it comes to living accommodation, because when he's at a show, all he's got is the rather exclusive pod on the back there. But what an interesting vehicle this Mack is, from 1944. Now, yes, this is a commercial vehicle.